Today, I am going to talk a little bit about our hybrid cloud experience and the role AWS Gateway, Storage Gateway plays. A little bit about ourselves. We discover, develop, and deliver innovative medicines to our patients. We offer drugs in oncology, immunosciences, and fibrosis. So for us, it's all about data. Data is growing at exponential rate in our labs and also in clinical settings. Just over 3 years, we were talking about 100 terabytes a year to tens of petabytes a year, right? So growth rate is exponential and it keeps growing. So what drives this huge growth in the data set? So next-gen sequencing is sequencing of your DNA, RNA, right? And the price of sequencing the gene exponentially fell down over the last 10 years, right? Which drove the use of sequencing a lot more and is now a central piece of how scientific biological data is understood. Scientific insights are understood, and it helps in innovating and discovering new drugs. So we have many different scientific data sets today in our hybrid cloud environment. The list keeps growing. Just on a technical note, raw data generated from the labs need to get to cloud for processing and analytics, right? And that is the function of Storage Gateway in our hybrid cloud workflow, right? We have been using virtual storage gateways for a few years now, but the advent of the hardware appliance, storage appliance, last year, since we have been complementing our different ways that we get the data to the cloud. Scratch space is a storage area in EC2 with high IOPS. Results data is, of course, shared internally and externally, so we use EFS. And there's a vast amount of external data that gets combined to get more insights. So why is the data complex? The data is complex because it is high velocity and high volume. Petabyte scale needs different services, different technologies to handle it, right? On a technical side, there is also a limitation. Instruments are only NFS compliant, so we only have POSIX metadata. But when it reaches cloud, we keep it on object storage, we keep it on S3. S3 is our foundation for our data lakes as well as our processing, right? So we have to enrich the data. When we capture the data, we can only capture POSIX metadata, and scientific data, business data is kept in databases. When it reaches cloud, we need to enrich it before we analyze. So what is a complete solution on a hybrid cloud? It's not just moving the data. Once we get there, there are many hundreds of EC2 instances in burst computing mode that analyze the data. The data is kept in catalogs, technical data, and domain-specific business data sets. Graph databases are used to derive relationships between the data sets, and then it ends up in our data lake. So there is new to us is also machine learning and deep learning. Since last 2 years, we have been increasingly deploying our machine learning to our data sets to understand it. Flow cytometry, if you are from life sciences, you are familiar with this. Genomics data sets, flow cytometric data sets, and image management is very unique to our industry and requires some custom algorithms, right? So let me dwell a little bit on the pipeline and the use of gateways for us, right? Instrument data captured on NAS devices need to be sent to the cloud. And there are several ways we do it. our legacy data is moved using Snowball, right? And our newly created data goes through our file gateways. We have also used SFTPs to move the data. We also use data sync. So there are several different AWS services that we use to move the data over direct connect, right? Once it ends it in S3 buckets, it needs to be cataloged, indexed, right, and then analyzed using analytical tools, depending on what type of data it is. Right. Many a times for image data sets, they need to be converted. So there are double copies, raw data copies, and converted data copies. Right. So for example, radiology data is DICOM images. High content screening is very specific images. Now they need to be converted to standard TIFF or JPEG format to be analyzed and stitched together for viewing. Right. So very specific to life sciences, but not unique. Right. So how do we actually use? Why use AWS Gateway appliance? Right. So there are three core reasons why we use the Gateway appliance, right? The onboard cache is extremely important for us because it creates asynchronicity between our lab workflows and the data transfer to cloud. Very, very important, right? The Gateway also does conversion from NFS to S3 automatically for us. A lot of services AWS built for us, so we don't have to do that. For example, compression of the data, encryption of the data. So we can safely move our data over the wire and keep it encrypted on S3 as well. Right. So that's the second. And the third very important thing is once the data is moved, there are some instances where we actually have on-prem applications looking at this data. So it's very important to have AWS Gateway, and it serves a function. We use it in the file mode, not the volume or block mode. So getting into S3 is after the, and to prepare it for downstream processing, there are many things which are essential to give a complete hybrid solution, right? With this data transfer to S3, the role of gateway is only when on-prem applications need to look at it, right? But there is a lot of processing done downstream. Business data is kept in business metadata catalogs. We use graph databases to do relationships. And depending on the type of the data, we use, for example, genomics would use ontologies to understand the data related. Image data sets need proprietary analysis tools, right? So depending on the type and domain, we use different technologies, right? And then it ends up in the data lake. That's where it is exposed to visualization tools, understanding the data, queries, and analysis of the data as well. So that looks like that's, and special to image management is the image transformation, right? Many or all of our image applications go through this process of conversion. Right, many of the radiology, histology images need to be stitched back for viewing, right? So many different serverless services we use to do that as well, right? So it is not just the gateway, but many services, AWS services that we use to provide a complete hybrid solution. So that is our journey of hybrid solution, hybrid cloud, and use of AWS Gateway appliance today. Thank you.